The Britannia project was a year-long project that started in September with grade 10 students visiting UBC. We then had a session in October and in January, and then we finished in May with our visit to Musqueam and building water filters.
So in the classroom, the students test different things like the pH and parts per million of the water, and hopefully can apply some of an Indigenous knowledge to their own filters.
Hey everyone, my name is Kachlia, my English name is Christy Charles, and I come from here in Musqueam. I was able to sit with the students from Britannia and share a little bit about who I am. My workshop was introducing herself in Musqueam, and what it is just standing up and being proud and representing who you are and where you come from. Also sharing with them protocols of Musqueam people, why we do land acknowledgements, and just the history of the city of Vancouver.
We took a tour around Musqueam and we had three different workshops. I learned the basic greetings such as like Haichka. We also learned about the sewer system in Vancouver, which was really interesting because all the sewage in Vancouver ends up in Musqueam and then they have to filter it out.
It was surprising to see how like largely they do the scale because it's so different than how we do it here, and it's good to take a lesson from what they do there in order to put it into the classroom. At a moment we went to go see a carver and it was good to see how they use their environment.
Physically being there was different than just having someone to come in and visit, because that's usually what happens. They would just come in and they would tell you their story, as opposed to actually being on the land. It felt a lot more personal to us. And when I was sitting there, I was like, okay, this is what we're talking about, this is what we're trying to save, and this is why we're doing this.
I'm Larry Grant. I'm from the community of Musqueam. At the workshop I was in this morning, these young students are getting a little bit of hands-on oral knowledge from our knowledge keepers. How our oral knowledge was always passed from generation to generation. It was what today is called land-based learning. But what it actually is through observation and listening and seeing how these results come about.
One of the nice things about coming here today is that they're just here and they're listening. And I really hope that that can translate into the classroom, and it doesn't have to be so much about the right answer or the wrong answer.
In the future, we are aiming to continue to keep our relationships that we built with the elders and the knowledge keepers. And we're also hoping to use this as a model for other schools so that they can incorporate InSTEM into their curriculum. Indigenous knowledge is scientific at its root, so we're trying to combine these two things as part of our movement through truth and reconciliation.